friends. If you catch me at the border, I got visas in my name. If you come around, hey, I'll make them all day. I get one down in a second if you wait. I fly like paper, get high like planes. If you catch me at the border, I got visas in my name. If you come around, hey, I'll make them all day. I get one down in a second if you wait.
Welcome to Hamstock.
Woo!
I can't hear myself.
Man who did it all.
Don't wait for me, Charlie.
How you doing? We have a little poem for you today. You know, I just recently met the love of my life, and I just want to dedicate this to her in her absence. And they're gonna play a little behind me. It's called "Love of My Life."
Just when I thought things couldn't get any worse, it got better. I've come into the relationship with the love of my life. It was the usual Friday, glasses were not on my mind. Traded from a bummer tie for casual sharpness, slicing the very hair I walked through. Yes, man, I was sharp. Perfect time to see B. Brown wrapped in a green and yellow velvet lace dress, filling fully a white blouse, hiding from the sun underneath the wide-brimmed Sunday yellow hat, bear hugged by a green ribbon. You know that eye? Yeah, she gave me that eye. It was a confidence booster. Hadn't seen in a while, made me smile for a sec, but then it get real serious. On a serious Sam tip, the games have begun. Our eyes met and were one, correcting organical rhythm, hitting our systems unmechanical, so natural, flowing freely into conversation. We communicated lovely. I could tell that she was hungry, needed to fill the tank from her circle, her hand moving around her stomach. So we ate together, faced towards each other, where the high tables are in the rack. We sat. First time, I wanna ask her for a map. I played it cool. I know I'll probably see her again. So she went her way, and I went mine. But from that day on, we steadily began to cheer the more and more. Time unveiled her sweetheart. Brother, she's a strong, intelligent B. Brown. One day we were chilling, me and her, and somebody interrupted our daily chill to interview her on her thoughts of the upcoming election. She was so eloquent to hear her speak is to listen. Right then I knew she was a keeper. I couldn't be a cheater and find out one cheaper. She was a keeper. I had to go deeper into the far realms of her mind. We became connected. Didn't have to talk, just complete eye talk. Stuttering only when our eyes became dry and needed a blink. Other than that, that connection between a man and a woman was there. Yo, you've got to meet her. To meet the love of my life. Her name is Ruth. Her friends call her the truth, and rightfully so. Our usual time together, we spend reading the word and praying. We've grown as a couple and can tell when she's not quite feeling herself. And interact with a well-placed smile. Now to successfully do this, you have to look into her eyes and then look away. Then look again. This time with a more earnest stare, complimented with the honest showing of teeth. Just a hint of her eyes spasm now, not too much now, so no mistake, your election for an epileptic episode. Now, finally, beneath the fine lip, a faint quiver. My B. Brown's day is completely turned around. Our interaction with another, as I feel, a novelty, unique and original, and check our priorities, and kept the simple principles. We don't suffocate our lives every day, physically sting each other, you know, every single day. I got to admit, mentally, I find them always on my mind, all the time. But nothing ever gets stale. Everything seems to pair when compared to my belle, my best friend always on my mind, my can't get enough of my, I think I want to marry her, get down on one knee with an engagement ring, fuck friends working overtime, over my limit. I know, it's serious. I think I want to marry the girl. But
You know, no girl is perfect.
There's always that one thing about a girl you don't like. That one thing. That one thing. Well, the one thing about Ruth, to tell the truth, is we never met.